We are entering.
Not going yet.
Huh? Oh, the caverns. We are entering the caverns at what's this place called?
Oh, Indian Caverns. Ohio
something Indian caverns. Caverns in Columbus, Ohio. Ready? We ask you to not touch the walls or ceiling of the caverns and stay on the paved walkways at all times. And we should not have to remind you to refrain from lighting on the cavern walls. Unfortunately, many people in the past have not understood the permanent damage that they may have done. We ask you don't add to their mistakes. If you have any questions after the tour, please feel free to ask the attendant. Oh, by the way, please watch your step and use the handrails at all times. If you do start to slip and fall, we ask that you scream loudly so that those in front of you can get out of the way. If you will, please walk to the bottom of the steps where you will be about 55 feet below ground level and be surrounded by a large limestone. Follow the passageway to the ground and walk the stairs to sign number 2 on the tour. Arrow passageway.
Executed?
Executed.
Interesting.
Some spelling errors. There's a headstone. Just south of the Columbus Zoo, where Leather Lips is believed to be buried.
What?
Sure. After. We won. Spot number 3. Droopy in here. Getting wet. Good thing I got my raincoat on.
Same service in here as I do at our house.
Terrible.
It's done. There I go.
Guys! I supposed to make it down this without touching the walls?
You can touch the walls, I think.
He said don't touch the walls.
Well, I thought they just didn't want you lighting up their eyes.
Oh. Gotta do some crawling through here. Narrow spaces. Huh?
How do the Indians see down here?
With their hands.
We're going deeper in the cave. We may never come back. This could be the end.
Moving on. It's a good thing we're not very large people.
You what?
I said it's a good thing we're not very large people.
That's right.
Well, I guess that's for the Lord.
I'm going to be able to fit through here with the backpack on.
Ceiling's pretty high in here. Look, they've used pipe. Is that piping?
Yeah. Not sure why that's there. Saw that earlier. I have some good wiring. Oh, wow.
That's gonna fall on your head.
Yeah, it sure looks like it. We may never get out of here.
Like this piece right here fell.
Yeah. It's wedged there.
This is pretty crazy.
This might be the burial ground. But...
I think it would have a sign, wouldn't it? Yeah. I thought burial grounds was the other direction.
I don't know. We're lost right now. We may never get back.
Let's take a look at the map under this light. Went to stop number 4, so we're in the tower room.
Ah.
We passed the cathedral hall, which was 105 feet below the surface.
Wow.
So now we're going to go to stop 5.
Where's the burial ground?
And see the burial ground.
Burial ground.
What is somebody like trying to climb up in there?
I don't know.
Stick their finger in there? Nasty. Hey, look at this child's footprint that is permanently in the stone.
Yeah, that comes over here. That is kind of weird. Awesome.
How long will it take Word to take a picture?
I forgot your camera's still rolling.
Still rolling.
Great location for the haunted.
Hold on, it's right above my head.
Area.
This would be terrifying as a haunted area. I do believe I would probably die. You know you can stand up, your head's not gonna hit. And pull the hold up the ceiling.
Oh wow. Let's
go for that. Somebody left their mask. There's a sign. This must be the Hopewell. Oh, we also learned about them. Okay, so we must be here. Ish. I'm guessing. The hole. Don't step in the hole. Mr. Lightman, could you provide some light?
Yeah.
For our viewing pleasure.
I wonder if that's the burial ground.
I think it may be the other direction. Maybe it is. I don't know. I think there's
this set. It was a bunch of rocks piled.
You really want to find those burial grounds, don't you?
Yes.
I'm gonna have to touch those walls. Touch the walls.
Air Force SpongeBob.
This isn't the burial grounds? More light. Brighter light.
That might be.
So this is the Hopewell and the Wyandotte, right?
The what?
The Hopewell and the Wyandotte?
I don't remember the first one, but yeah, the Wyandotte. Hello.
Hello.
Excuse us.
Uh-huh. Anything interesting down here?
Yes no. And no.
Okay.
Just kind of depends on how much you use your imagination.
Yeah, they said, like, keep on making, like, right-hand turns, right?
I don't know. We've just kind of been roaming.
Yeah, we're following the numbers. We went through the numbers 1 through 5.
Yeah.
All right. I think that's it, dear.
I think it is.
Anything else you want to go back and see? Are you ready to head up?
Yeah.
No, that's fine. Let's head up a different way than we came down.
I don't think there is an alternative route.
Okay, that's fine.
I think there's only one entrance and one exit.
That is fine.
So, back.
Didn't we come down this and then we went down? We went that way. Oh, okay.
To two.
Yeah, you're right. Okay.
Though I don't know where one was.
Interesting. Maybe the Indians didn't use the letter one.
I don't think we use the letter one either.
They're respecting their use of not using the number one.
It's a little stinky.
Must be all the stalactites.
Oh, number one is right here, I think. The natural entrance. Yeah.
So really, it must have started in the actual first.
Well, the sign says natural entrance down there.
Oh.
Oh. Hello.
Hello.
The date of the first inscription down in the cave with a name on it from 1821.
Oh.
Like first explorer.
So we've been learning about all these things. We learned about the three sisters. And we learned about the Dena people. And we learned about the Wyandot. And we learned about the Hopewell. Look at the baby moccasins.
I want to feel a good chill.
This is Bill Moose Crowfoot, and he is believed to be the last Wyandot Indian in the state of Ohio. Very cool. What'd you think?
Pretty cool. Haven't been in caves in a long time. Worth it.